Y254. Imagine.
Welcome back and thank you for staying with us on Y254. If you're just joining us tonight, we're talking about goal setting and we've discussed quite a number of things. We've talked about the impact of goal setting. We've also tried to look at how do we get to balance. Leah has mentioned how she's been able to balance our goals, like through all the aspects that she has to set goals in her life. Talk to us across social media platforms at Y254 channel. You can also reach me at Patricia Marioki. So John, let me bring you on the part where balancing every goal that you set. Mm-hmm. Because as Leah said, sometimes you notice that your educational goals are going so well,
yes.
Your business goals are going so well, yes. But there's a disconnect when it comes to everything that you wanted to achieve holistically. Mm. So how do we create that balance?
Well, I think one, it's important to always have a point where you get to review mm-hmm. whatever you do, mm-hmm. because I always believe that enough times, we are quick to set goals, mm-hmm. and at times you get too busy mm-hmm. trying to actually achieve these goals to an extent where you don't have even time to review.
Okay.
So I always believe that it's very important for you to set time mm-hmm. to have a review of these goals that you've set. Mm-hmm. As a matter of fact, I think to a great extent also most people fear failure.
Mm-hmm.
And we fail to want to embrace whatever it is that we have been able to encounter
mm-hmm.
to an extent where we shy away from mm-hmm. having to deal with the reality at hand.
Mm-hmm.
I think I'm inspired by this guy, the late Nelson Mandela,
mm-hmm.
Who by the time he was about to die, he had written a book. And in this book, he was talking about the courage to face oneself,
mm-hmm.
Because most of the times you find people are not quick enough to even create time to face themselves, mm-hmm. to be able to have a review of who they are or whatever they are doing. And I think for me, it's also important because life has a way of, bringing about different results. So there are times you'll be successful in what you do, there are times you'll be failing in what you do. So
yeah.
I think you need to have a review mm-hmm. of the same. And most still also, as you also get to set these goals that you're setting, it's also very important for you to also be a bit practical,
okay.
in terms of the things that you're trying to achieve.
Mm-hmm.
Because I always say that, I remember at one point, some time back, we were fairly young and we were being asked, so what do you want to do in another 5 years?
Mm-hmm.
And back then we were still early in our 20s and mm-hmm. one guy said that he wanted to have a child in class 4, at that particular time. And it got me thinking that this guy was not married,
mm-hmm.
he didn't have a kid, so you'd imagine within 5 years having a kid in class 4, not unless it's adoption or whatever,
yeah.
If it's so through realistic. The due process, so it's good to be realistic in whatever you do.
We can't talk about goals without talking about being specific with your goals. They're supposed to be measurable goals. They're supposed to be actionable. They're also supposed to look at time. So I'd like to bring you in on this one, Leah. How are we able to make sure that we're setting realistic goals? Because I believe people out here set goals, but the moment you try to listen to the goals that someone has set, you even wonder, is the timeline that you've given to them, is it enough for you to be able to get to that point? So how do we set realistic goals?
How you can set realistic goals is by picking on one big goal in your area,
mm-hmm.
in your area of focus.
Mm-hmm.
Like for example, if I want to lose, 10 kilograms
mm-hmm.
in the year 2020?
Mm-hmm. 2021,
sorry.
Mm-hmm.
Right. I beg your pardon. In the year 2021.
Mm-hmm.
So if I want to lose 10 kgs, is that realistic?
Mm-hmm.
What you need to have to make it realistic is have what we call a goal roadmap.
Mm-hmm.
A roadmap will give you step by step. For me to achieve myself losing 10 kgs within a short time, say even if it's within 6 months,
mm-hmm.
what are the things that I need to do?
Mm-hmm.
I need to eat healthy. You
mm-hmm.
need to know, for your goal to be realistic, you need to know the steps you need to take
okay.
for you to get from point A to B.
Mm-hmm.
Am I going to eat healthy? Am I going to exercise?
Mm-hmm.
Am I going to be more careful with my mind? I'm going to be mindful of what is it that I allow to get into my brain.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. So for it to be realistic, also you have to check your timeline. You also have to check in terms of what is it that I need to do to get there. But also in the process of being realistic, we can at times limit ourselves.
Okay.
Sometimes I like it when especially young people take big audacious goals. Because, you know, like they say, a dream for the sky, you know, you know, you could land in there, in the stars. Don't be afraid to dream big.
Yeah.
It's just that give it a time. You might say, I want to earn a million a month. Give yourself time, even if you, it's going to be a long-term goal.
Okay.
And then you begin having realistic steps to get there. Do I need to go back to school to get more skilled? What are the steps that I need to take for me to get to my big audacious? You know, dream, yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
So we can't talk about goal setting without talking about what attitude do you bring? When you sit down and say, at the end of this year, I want to buy a car. What attitude, as you go out there to look for the money, as you go out there to look for whatever it is, resource that you need to achieve a certain goal, you can't do that without embracing a positive attitude. So how do we do that, John? How do how do people now adopt maintaining a very positive attitude throughout this process?
Yes. So now I want to put something there that also answer or get to respond to that. I say that where we're looking at also setting goals, one of the end games you want to seek is to be successful. And one thing I've learned about success, success has dues that you have to pay. You know? And if people have that at the bottom of their heart, it means that, you know, that is actually in itself a driving force, because in whichever line you are seeking to become successful, there are those requirements that are, you know, set for you to get to achieve, that are set for you to get to conquer. So it means that in your mind, you have to have this mindset, you know, when you talk about attitude. I also think it's so much about the mindset that you have, that whatever you seek to do, for you, you're not trying, you know, you're actually seeking to get to see the end of it in a bigger way. So one thing I always say, and I'll also actually echo what has actually been mentioned, is that even in your setting of goals, make these goals to actually also be bold. Because as a matter of fact, it takes the same amount of energy, or rather it takes the same amount of energy to make or to have small goals as well as big goals. So why do you have to actually lose your energy on small goals, you know? That kind of thinking is very important. Actually, when you talk about boldness, you're also talking about big, you know? And big does not mean that you're also not realistic. As a matter of fact, I think in this dreaming that we have, even the people who dream at night and those who dream during daytime, both of them, they end up dreaming, you know? So at, I know, by and large, if you're actually trying to think in this particular line, you'll find that the driving force in regards to what you want to seek to achieve will be what will actually be pushing you. I always try to relate goal setting to this aspect that, number one, the best time to plant a tree was 25 years ago.
For each of grown.
And that simply means there's some of us who in our lives right now, we say, I wish I did whatever I was supposed to have done 25 years ago or a long time ago, because I would have been in this particular place. But also say, where this attitude is concerned, the second best time to plant a tree, it is now.
Okay. As we come to, as you wind up on this discussion tonight, Leah, accountability. Do I need an accountability partner, or how can I also be accountable by myself in the goals that I have set for myself?
It's very important for you to have an accountability partner. Actually, this one from my personal experience is that I've been able to achieve more of my goals when I have an accountability partner. You know, these days you're not limited by boundaries. My accountability partner is all the way in Malawi. And we leave each other voice notes. This week, this is my goal. And we keep each other accountable. We started, chose my business accountability partner. And as we kept growing, we have developed a friendship that now we are even keeping each other accountable when it comes to our health. So we call each other, you know, what milestones you want to hit this week, and we keep each other accountable. We are each other cheerleaders. So it's very important for you to look for an accountability partner. It doesn't have to be your family member, but it has to be somebody you can trust with you, because these goals are what are going to make you become whoever you want to become. It has to be somebody you can trust with these goals, somebody who can cheer you on, somebody who can look you in the eye and tell you, you know, now you're really messing up. and somebody who is going to work with you, celebrate with you the wins mm-hmm. once you have achieved this goal. So it's very key. Don't be afraid to try. Reach out to somebody who you feel you're aligned in terms of goals. Mm-hmm. It can be even people who are trying to achieve other things, but this is somebody you know who is going to be consistent, is going to be in your corner. Eh? Mm-hmm. When you're doing this, they're in your corner and they are going to support you. And you should also offer the same to them, because a relationship is more beneficial when it's mutual.
Yeah.
Yeah, so that you're not becoming a parasite.
Mm-hmm. So
it's a give and take situation.
Yeah.
And it has worked so well. Mm-hmm. In fact, like when you're doing something, you can actually cross-check with them and then mm-hmm. they give you ideas, critique it, you know. Like we always tell each other, you know me, I'm looking at it with a critical eye. Mm-hmm. It's good, but just know that I'm looking at it with a critical eye, and we don't take offense because, you know, it is for our betterment. So get an accountability partner. If the relationship does not work, move on to the next one until you find the right one. You know, like in Kenya, I know we have these groups, Sister Kuja Hapa, eh? Mm-hmm. You know, when you see something, those people, when they see an opportunity for you, they'll tell you, come here,
yeah.
come and camp here. This mm-hmm. is where the opportunity is.
Okay.
And accountability works very well, because sometimes you can feel you're alone in this journey of trying, especially when you're going for big dreams. It's a lonely journey.
So you need someone.
You need someone to walk with you the journey.
Okay.
Yes.
John, for young people watching us tonight, mm-hmm. when it comes to focus, like literally being able to focus on every goal and every dream and everything that you set for yourself, it doesn't matter in what area or what aspect of your life, how do they maintain that focus? 30 seconds.
Yes. Mm-hmm. So I think where we're looking at focus, it's important to actually narrow down. Mm-hmm. in whatever you seek to achieve.
Mm-hmm.
And that means there could be so many things that probably you may have set mm-hmm. to do,
mm-hmm.
but if you can actually get to narrow down to whatever you want to achieve, I can say even that one big thing that mm-hmm. you want to seek to do,
mm-hmm.
because that one big thing could also have other things that could also be attached to it.
Yeah.
So narrow down to that one big thing that you'd want to do,
mm-hmm.
and then from there you can now be able to build, because if you're able to achieve one major, you know, thing, and mm-hmm. you have that as a big win,
okay.
of course you're also able to come and build from that, and then of course with this, with the other wins, you'll be able now to get to conquer and conquer more, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So get narrowed down from there with that win, get to build on that, like that, like that.
Mm-hmm.
And of course you'll be able to have that focus, because otherwise if you're distracted, if you're chasing a lot of things, I always say a person going after an elephant does not go throwing stones to birds,
mm-hmm.
you know. So
mm-hmm.
get to focus on the elephant,
mm-hmm.
stop wasting your energy and time mm-hmm. throwing stones to the birds that are along the way in your journey of life.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
One thing that if I'm sitting, someone watching us tonight, and they're now like, I think I need to set goals, and there's something I've learned,
mm-hmm.
what should they consider before they set those goals? 30 seconds.
You just have to know your purpose.
Mm-hmm.
Because once you know what your purpose is, then you start aligning your goals
mm-hmm.
towards your
purpose.
Yes. Mm-hmm. So as you set your goals, you know what your purpose is.
Mm-hmm.
How can you know your purpose? It's a process. You cannot know it in one day. And remember, you're an evolving being.
Okay.
And sometimes you might think this is my purpose, then you achieve it and God shows you
yeah.
something new to try.
Yeah.
Just keep grinding, keep on your grind. That's what I can say.
Okay.
When you fall, get up.
Mm-hmm.
Fall down 10 times.
Okay.
Wake up 11 times.
Okay.
Yes.
Thank you very much for finding the time to be here with us tonight. I hope that if you were watching us tonight, this has been a very informative discussion. I also have taken one or two points home, and I hope that as we set goals year 2021, we are going to be setting realistic goals and goals that we know that we are able to attain. So thank you very much for being with us. Next week, same time, we're going to be diving onto career goals, because today we didn't touch anything on career goals. So next week we talk about career goals. Thank you very much. My name is Patricia Morioki. Have yourselves a very good night.